Into existence. Okay. I'm not denying. I'm not going to come and say to you, the way I came into existence is the same way. Then you're going to say, I don't know. Because the way you came into existence is not the same as the universe. I'm with
What's
you.
What's wrong with this example? This is Turkish, you're Turkish.
No.
What's wrong with it?
No, because we are both, made in Turkey, but we are both not made the same way.
Okay. So now it's relevant, but when we talk about the universe, it's irrelevant. That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay, I'm really trying to understand you here.
You made the process relevant here.
No. I'm talking about the fact is here.
Yeah.
The way the universe was made is different the way I was made.
Yeah.
I'm with you.
But I'm talking about this. Why is it relevant how it's made?
That's what I'm saying. The way the universe came into existence
is
not the same way I came into existence.
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. But I'm just saying, have we both come into existence?
Yeah.
Okay.
But there are theories, no, but we'll talk about that.
We'll talk about the theory later.
Yeah.
Right now, we can agree that the universe and myself came into existence.
Okay, so the deductive argument is true.
Okay, one second.
Deductive argument, this is still true.
Yes.
Everything
that begins to exist has a cause. Yes.
The universe began to
exist, therefore it requires a cause.
Okay.
So, therefore, look, I came into existence, I require a cause. The key words are here is this, existence and cause. That's my premise.
Okay.
I'm not talking about how did it come into it, how was it made. The universe came into existence, should require a cause.
Okay.
The key words again, existence and cause.
Okay.
Existence and cause.
You're saying the process is irrelevant, the definition of beginning to exist.
All I'm saying is, what's relevant to me and my premise is that when anything that begins to exist should have a cause.
Okay, but beginning to exist are two different ways, definitions.
Begin to exist is begin to exist. I don't know any other definition. Can you give me another definition of begin to exist?
What do you mean begin to exist?
You're telling me it's different. All I know is from begin to exist is something was not in existence and it came into existence.
Yeah,
do you know any other definitions?
In our concept, there's
okay,
time.
Can you give me
in
another?
The concept of the universe, there's no time.
Okay,
only concept.
Irrelevant. If it came into existence, that's what matters. Because if something comes into existence and another thing comes into existence, all I know is both of them came into existence. That's all I know.
It's a different type. Like you are a different type than this, so we can't equate you two. You're a human, this is water. It doesn't matter that they're both Turkish. Because you're two different types, listen to what I'm saying.
I know.
So why aren't you bringing that into the universe?
I am.
You're not. You're saying it's irrelevant.
Did this come into existence?
No, I'm not talking about coming. I'm talking about this document. I'm talking about
the existence. Did this water bottle come into existence?
Yeah.
Did I come into existence?
Yeah.
Does this have a cause?
Yeah.
Do I have a cause?
Yeah, but they're the same.
That's all I'm saying.
Because you both are in time.
We're different.
So it's the same. The universe wasn't in time when it began to exist. There was no time
before
it.
Look, you said it with your own mouth. There was no time when it came into existence.
No, you said...
At the time. Sorry.
You can go.
Look. What it is, because... What's the relevance of it? Chris.
I want to talk to him, please.
It's okay, look, I just want you to understand this, yeah? You agreed, you said, when the universe came into existence. I'm like, yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So, can we agree that me and the universe have a cause?
Sorry?
Can we agree that me and the universe have a cause?
Yeah, but it's not the same concept. That's what I'm
We'll come to the concept. Can we agree that he has a cause?
Yeah.
Okay, now we have agreed that there is a cause.
Yeah.
What I believe that there's a high intelligence. What do you believe? I believe.
Move on. I'm gonna ask you the question again.
Okay.
Why aren't you this if you're both Turkish? Answer the question.
Because that's a bottle
that
has no feelings, anything, and I do, and I can operate.
But they're both Turkish. They both, like you're saying, the two things began to exist.
Yes.
It doesn't matter.
That has a different existence. I have a different existence.
No, I'm not talking about the existence. You're not understanding what I'm trying to say. This is Turkish.
Yes.
Just like you're saying, this began to exist.
Yes.
You're Turkish. Just like you're saying, the universe began to exist.
Yes.
Why can't you say this is equal to this?
Because we're two different things. We are made from
It's a different concept. This is not an animate object.
Yes.
You're an animate object.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The same things with the universe. It's a different concept of beginning to exist. So you can't equate it.
No. What you're doing here is this. For example, that's an inanimate object.
Yeah.
I'm an animate.
It doesn't have to be animate or inanimate. You can. We're talking animal.
One second.
You can be an animal as well.
It doesn't have to be an animal. No. What I'm trying to say is this. Yeah. The way the universe, how it was created.
Yeah.
and how I am are two total things. I can speak, the universe can't.
Don't equate the two examples. I'm just giving you a metaphor, like an analogy.
No, I know, but
don't
you
equate this with this.
No, no, no, but I'm going with your analogy. You're saying, Ali, you both are Turkish, but that is different. So why are you not using that when you're comparing the universe? Yeah. Yeah? That's what you're saying.
You're saying it's irrelevant when we talk about the universe.
Is the universe, the universe, yeah? Okay. Does it have a soul? There's the universe. Can it speak?
No.
I can speak. There's the universe. Is there anything with me and the universe that has a correlation?
You're talking about the differences. I gave you one difference. Why aren't you making that difference relevant?
What's the difference?
That the beginning of the universe, when it began to exist, there was no time. When we talk about beginning to exist, there is time.
It's
a different concept.
No, but even if it's a different concept, it still has a beginning and it still has a cause. I still have a beginning. Look.
Your
premise is that time. Because that didn't have time and you have time, you guys are totally opposite. No.
I'm not saying it's opposite.
No.
I'm saying it's different.
No.
You said opposite.
Just because, one second.
I'm saying different.
Okay, me and a turtle, are we different?
No. What do you mean? No.
Me and a turtle, are we the same or different?
Different?
We're different.
Yeah.
Was the turtle born?
Yeah.
Was I born?
Yeah.
Does the turtle have a cause?
Yeah.
Do I have a cause?
Yeah. You're both in time. Stop equating you with a turtle. I'm going to keep repeating it. The universe
Either there's two things happening. Either we are not understanding each other, or on purpose, the topic's been diverted.
On purpose?
No, I'm asking something.
I'm not doing anything.
Okay. We came to an understanding that I exist, the universe exists.
Yeah.
The universe has a cause, I have a cause.
This is what I'm saying.
I'm saying, can you bring me evidence?
Just one last time. With this, you're making irrelevant the difference. With the universe, you're making irrelevant. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, what I'm saying
is this.
Since you agree that the universe exists and has a cause, what is that cause? Let's talk about what we agree on. What is the cause of the universe?
The topic
now? No, we're on the topic. We're on the topic. We're on the topic. Since we agree that the universe has existed, you said it with your own mouth, and you agree that it has a cause, what is the cause?
Said there's many theories.
Give me one of them.
There was a gaseous crystal that was very dense and then exploded.
So what, is this before time?
No, yeah, there was no time. Space and time was created when the universe was created.
Okay,
was
good. So, this is where the universe was created.
Yeah.
What was before that?
Before. One of the theories is...
No. What does a theory mean?
What do you mean?
What is a theory? No. When you say a theory,
yeah,
what does that mean?
It's a plausible idea.
I'm saying I don't want to go with could be, maybe, there is a chance. I'm saying, who told you that? You said that before the universe was created, there was a gas?
Yeah, gaseous state.
Okay. So,
it's a theory.
Okay, so, no. But what I'm trying to say to you is, what is the best possible explanation to explain the universe coming to existence?
Yeah.
This gas thing you're talking about, can you tell me a bit about it? How did it work?
I'm just asking, theories are irrelevant. They're not important anymore.
I'm just trying to understand, yeah? I'm saying to you, can it be there was a higher intelligence?
We're not talking about high intelligence right now.
Looking about the cause. Can the cause... Give me a second. Can there be the cause be a higher intelligence?
Maybe.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is, we agree that there was a beginning, so let's go with this. Either this universe came from nothing, either this universe created itself, either this universe was infinite, or this universe...
What's your definition of nothing? Zero
nothing.
Equals
the absolute of the absence of something.
Okay, can it ever be the case 0 equals 1? Just answer the question.
I'm going to come to you. So either we have these options. Either it came from nothing.
Yeah.
Either it created itself.
Yeah.
Either it was always there, or there's higher intelligence behind it. Okay. Let's talk about the first one. Can something come from nothing?
So 0 can equal to 1, right?
Can. No, I'm saying it can't.
Can, yeah.
No, it can't. I'm saying it can't.
Okay. If you define 1 and 0 in different ways, it can.
Okay.
If you define 0 to be a full box and 1 to be an empty box, then 0 equals 1. If you define this as a chicken and define that as a human, one human equals 0 chickens. So 0 can be equal to 1 if you define it differently.
Okay, so I'm going to go with the basic definition that universally everybody understands,
no.
Yeah?
You have to give them definitions.
No, I'm giving a definition.
Just one definition.
Nothing is the absence of something.
Yeah. Okay. No. But are we talking about the same thing here and here? When 0 equals 1?
My nothing is the absence of something.
Okay.
Nothing.
I'm not talking about definition of the term. I'm talking about the definition of the math.
I'm telling you, forget math. In math, there's infinite, but in the real world, there isn't. Yeah?
What do you mean?
In the real world, do we have infinite?
No. Okay. We're not talking about infinite. No,
I know. I'm saying my nothing is the absence of something. If there is nothing, can you get something from nothing? Yes or no? Or you can elaborate.
Sorry. Can you repeat the question?
My premise is this. From nothing cannot come something.
Yeah.
So can you prove to me how from nothing something
I'll
comes?
I'll answer your question if you answer my question. Can zero be equal to one?
No,
if
zero.
You define it differently.
No. So now you're playing. You're going to philosophy.
I'm not playing. I'm not playing with philosophy.
One second. I'm saying. I'm not going with you.
I'm saying all the math we do, we have to define it.
Okay, understand me. I'm not going to mathematics. I'm saying, what is zero to you?
Yeah.
To universally, to all of us, what is it?
Nothing of something. Of something.
No. I'm saying to you,
yeah.
Universally, when I go to somebody and say I have zero money.
Yeah.
Does he think I have £1 in my pocket?
Zero money, so nothing of something. That's what I'm trying to say. Not nothing. Nothing of something.
Okay, I have nothing of that something that he's asking.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm saying...
You have to define it.
So I'm saying, can something come from nothing?
Define what you mean.
Nothing,
something you're
nothing
talking about.
Is the absence of something. There is nothing.
Yeah.
Can something come into existence?
From the, something not... It can. I'll give you one theory.
Give me an example.
Okay. Do you know what the positron is?
No.
Or antiproton?
No. Nope.
Okay, for every particle, there's the antiparticle. They cancel each other out.
Okay.
So if everything cancels each other out, then there can be.
No.
I'm telling you one of the theories.
No. You said there's two particles that cancel each other out.
Yeah.
There are two particles that are in existence. I'm talking about nothing making
if
something.
If they cancel each other out, we're in nothing.
There's two something.
One second. If you do one plus one equals one.
I'm here. Yeah?
Yeah.
One second. Yeah. There's two particles cancel each other out.
Yeah.
I'm saying there was no particles. There was nothing there. Can it bring something?
Sorry?
The particles you were talking about,
yeah.
I'm saying you're talking about two particles canceling each other out.
Yeah.
I'm saying there was nothing there.
When they cancel each other out, it's still nothing. Let me just repeat
what I said.
When they cancel each other out, it's still nothing.
Brother, I'm saying those particles that cancel each other out, I'm saying they were not even there. There was nothing. So can it come? Please answer me. Can something come from nothing? It's a very simple question. I swear to God.
I showed you one way.
No, you did not. You showed me two particles that are in existence canceling each other out. I'm saying nothing was there. No particles. Why did you bring particles in there? I'm saying nothing.
No,
you're bringing something into it.
I'm not saying this is.
Look, once again, you're going to possibilities. Maybe theories. I'm just saying.
Is the Big Bang a theory or no?
Yeah, it's another theory.
Okay, then.
Yeah. So I'm
you
saying.
You like that theory, but
No. I'm just saying logically and rationally.
You use it a lot.
Not really. I don't usually. Sometimes I do. But what I'm trying to say is rationally. Rationally, I'm asking you. Can something come from nothing? Please, just answer me that. That's all I want from you.
No.
No. Okay. So we say bye-bye to that.
No, I'm not. I just explained to you.
But look. Can something come from nothing? Please, that's all I want.
One minus one is what?
Zero.
Okay, so it's zero and zero.
But you're saying one minus one. I'm saying there's zero at the beginning.
One minus one is what?
Brother.
Zero.
Zero.
So it's still zero at the beginning because they cancel each other out. What
brother,
don't you
brother.
Understand?
There was one.
You're talking. I'm saying.
They cancel each other
can
out.
Can I say the difference between
exist.
Me and you?
Yeah.
I'm saying, can zero equal one? You're saying, Ali, one second. There is one, take away one. I'm saying, why are you bringing one? I'm saying there is nothing.
I'm not saying one equals zero.
Brother, right now
we're not in one. We're in zero. That's what I'm saying.
Brother, you understand what I'm saying?
We're not in one. We're in zero.
I'm just asking a simple question.
Cancels each other out.
Look, I'm going to make this very simple.
Yeah.
Can nothingness, absolute nothingness, make something?
You understand what I just said?
I'm going to ask one more time.
Zero equals one.
I'm going to ask
right
one more time.
Right.
I'm gonna, no, no, no. You, I, you're talking.
Yeah.
No, no, no.
Say it again.
Please, just answer this question. Can nothing make something? That's all I want to know.
Can nothing make something?
Yeah.
Apply your theory to that now.
What's that?
Our concept of nothing?
Yes.
Our concept of nothing doesn't necessarily mean we know that.
I did
concept.
Not ask you that. All I ask is, can nothing make something?
Our concept,
brother?
No. But we don't know the universe. We don't know if it's the same concept.
Brother.
Listen to what
brother,
I'm saying.
Brother.
Our concept, no. But we don't know the concept.
Okay.
What you, okay, one second.
What you're doing is, that's the gap of, the science of the gaps, yeah? Yeah, it's basically what it is. Outside our universe, we don't know.
No,
maybe
I'm not saying outside. I'm saying the universe in itself.
I'm saying from what we know,
yeah.
Can we deduct to an understanding that from nothing comes?
Who told you that you know everything? Because when we talk about...
I'm talking about what I know.
Yeah, but when we talk about God, we know. When we talk about God, we say we don't know.
No.
When we talk about the universe, we say we do.
No, brother. It's not double standard.
Brother, please.
Does
God have a God?
Hello.
You don't know?
No, one second. I'm here, yeah? I'm saying something very simple, yeah? Nothing. We agreed that from our understanding and our realm, cause and effect, so from nothing cannot come something. Yes? So we say bye-bye to
our
nothing.
Concept.
From our concept and our what we know, from nothing, nothing comes.
Why don't you apply
comes.
That to God?
We haven't
because
come
you,
to him.
You know, I'm just saying, the concept,
we're gonna
that
come
concept
to him.
You don't apply to God. You say
but
we don't
how
know.
Do you know? We haven't even come to him yet.
You apply that God had a cause? You no, say that's, no, ir- that's you, stupid you, to say.
But have
God.
We come to that yet?
Yeah.
So 1 second. Huh? So God creates the universe with nothing, innit? No, what do you mean nothing?
You say Allah, God creates.
Look, look, look, I'm coming, I'm coming to you. No, no, no. I'm coming, let's go under the tree. I'm saying if it came
anything we know.
What do you know?
I'm saying no, no, no, 1 second, 1 second, we'll change the topic here. If God exists, God creates the universe. Yeah? Now I'm saying something very simple, yeah? Therefore, we cannot say it came from nothing. Yeah?
Yeah, well, we didn't finish with that one.
No, we finished it. We finished this very beautifully, yeah? Can the universe create itself?
What?
Can the universe create itself?
I told you I don't want to talk about other ones because we
no, no, no. See, that's what I'm saying. I'm building.
This is my for the one that Chris. You just used.
No, no. All I'm saying is this, yeah. Can the universe create
for
itself?
For the one that you just used, you're using your knowledge. It's not complete.
No,
look,
no.
Can you be a lamp? Can you be a lamp? Answer the question.
Somebody if you say yeah.
Can you be a lamp?
Somebody if you say yeah.
Okay. A particle can be a particle and a wave.
Yeah.
That's more impossible than you being a lamp. So don't say
can
you can't
go,
be a lamp.
Can we go under the tree?
Do you understand what I just said?
Yeah. 1 second, sorry. I'm just trying.
They're going to move, yeah? Wait. Are you not moving?
No, I want to, but is there like, can we go under this tree or something?
Nothing comes from nothing, it's rain. Hold on.
Hold on.
But it's cold will come from that, trust me.
Let's go there.
40 degrees, my friend, I don't care.
Oh, come on.
Are you Jamaican?
Oh, snap.
No, I come from minus 40.
Whereabouts?
Canadian.
You didn't drop in the right place, don't worry.
Canadian.
You're
from America.
That's from last time.
Let me.
Yeah, you want to go there?
Chris, let's go there. Yo, guys, we're going under there, bro. Chris, come here. Yeah, we're doing that, it's cool, yeah? Chris, where's Chris? Chris! Salam, how you doing?
What's this? Reputation of Tommy Robinson.
How you doing, okay?
Ali,
yeah? Yeah.
Nasıl?
Nasıl?
İstanbul.
Yeah.